Well, here I am, Saturday morning, and as promised, I'm going to be walking part of the old S&D track bed. Behind me, you'll see the line as it was going towards Templecombe, now part of the Gartel Railway. And if I swing round, behind me is the track bed going on towards Henstridge and where I shall be walking this morning. Look out for some more pictures. Well, I've just come up the old track bed so far, and unfortunately my route is barred, so I'm going to have to go back to the car and see if I can access this a little bit further along down the line. Right, okay, onwards and upwards. Okay, I've rejoined the railway at the nearest point possible. This is the road bridge that crosses over at Henstridge on the A30 crosses it. As you can see, quite overgrown. But still quite a nice road bridge. And I'm going to be walking on down now towards the crossing point and the old station house. sleepers there making up the steps. Else visible here railway wise, completely obliterated apart from the track bed. Coming up now to the crossing and the old station house on our right hand side. Two splendid looking crossing posts, still with their furniture on them. And if we swing round, the old gates look like the original hinges, as far as I can see. Fabulous that they've been left here. Right, let's move on the track bed towards Sturminster Newton. Old railway fence posts in the hedge there. Another old railway fence post, definitely seen better days. walking along the path. Still see evidence of ballast. Like the end of the line for me, as it goes straight across into somebody's garden. But we'll go and have a look at the crossing posts. Grand as the others, so there's a old piece of rail. The other one totally obscured with ivy. Ladies and gentlemen, is where it went, straight through this person's driveway and out the other side. This is actually called Crossing Cottage for very obvious reasons. Nice little cottage for the crossing keeper to live in.